I, as a person who's from a non-medical background, has understood this and will be going out of this session with pride that, you know, I've learned something very valuable today.
जे कोणी हा एपिसोड ऐकत आहे त्यांना माझी रिक्वेस्ट आहे की डेस्मॉन लॉरी यांनी जो एफर्ट्स घेतलेला आहे की हा मेसेज पास करायला, तर त्या पर्पजला प्लीज तुम्ही कोऑपरेट करा, सपोर्ट करा. आणि हा जो व्हिडिओ आहे तो जेवढा तुम्हाला सर्क्युलेट करता येईल, व्हायरल करता येईल, शेअर करता येईल, तो प्लीज करा. आणि त्याचबरोबर काहीही तुम्हाला इन्फॉर्मेशन वगैरे पाहिजे असेल तर यू कॅन कॉन्टॅक्ट डेस्मॉनला किंवा लॉरीला, तुम्ही कम्युनिकेट करा, माझ्यापर्यंत तो येईल. आणि 24/7 कधीही कुठेही ऑल ओव्हर इंडियामध्ये तुम्हाला काहीही हेल्प लागली रिलेटेड टू ब्लड कॉम्पोनंट, प्लाझ्मा, प्लेटलेट्स, ऍज अ टीम मी माझ्या साईडने अश्युअर करतो की मी डेस्मॉन लॉरी यांच्या सोबत आहे आणि आम्ही तुमच्यापर्यंत पोहोचू आणि जेवढी काही मदत करता येईल तेवढी करू. प्लीज आम्हाला हेल्प करा. थँक्यू.
वेलकम बॅक टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ SYWK पॉडकास्ट, वेन नो टॉपिक इज ऑफ लिमिट्स. Do you know there are many people, including me, who don't know the real meaning of donating blood or what actually is platelet donation? But trust me, after having a conversation with my guest, I have understood the importance of donating blood. And even though I come from a non-medical background, I still could understand the concept since my guest has explained it in an extremely simple way. So my guest for today's episode is someone who is an inspirational for all. He has become the most frequent platelet donor and so far he has donated around 170 times. And also, he has been blessed with a rare blood group called AB negative. His efforts were even applauded by the Central Health Ministry and he was awarded the title Young Medical Scientist. Isn't that amazing? He has also started an initiative called as Blood Bank Tourism to promote platelet donation. Many youths are now part of this initiative. If you would like to be part of this group, please feel free to contact my guest, who is the one and only Mr. Vishwajit Kashid. So listen to our conversation till the end and for sure you will be learning something new which will eventually help you save others' life in future. So welcome Vishwajit sir to my podcast channel SYWK and welcome Larry as well for the third time. Welcome, and it's an honor to have you both, and we will be talking about platelets and how important platelets are.
Thank you Desmond. I'm extremely grateful for having me over and discussing on such a important topic. Thank you so much.
Thanks Desmond.
The first question I would like to ask Vishwajit sir is, if you can just tell us what exactly are platelets, if you can just simplify this as well.
Okay, before talking about what are platelets, let me tell you, most of the people are surprised around the world why these blood donation camps are going on over the year. Why we do not, having a proper system where we can store the blood. So guys, always remember, all over these blood donation camps are not happening for these RBCs. Majorly, people have a confusion. They think that the blood donation camps are happened to collect the blood. Not at all. The real hero in that blood donation are your platelets. Okay. So, entire world, the most demanding product out of your blood is not RBC, it is the platelets. So, how one can donate a platelets? Okay. Before that, I'll tell you which patients require platelets. First, cancer patients. Okay, after chemotherapy, platelets goes down. There, the platelets are required. Second, burn patients. Third, new surgeries. The kids below 2 years, we never transfuse them a blood like RBC. We transfuse them the combination of plasma and platelets to them. So there, you need a lot of platelets. So such kind of serious patients always are in demand of platelets. The normal range of platelets in our human body when you are healthy is between 1.5 lakh to 4.5 lakh. Okay, that is the normal range, 1.5 lakh to 4.5 lakh. Suppose if you go through some minor disease like fever, what happens is once you have a fever, you feel like you develop the nausea or you develop the weakness. Weakness is nothing but dropping of your platelet count. Okay, it drops to 1 lakh or maybe around 85,000. Once the platelet count is low, then you feel like fatigue or, you know, weakness gets developed. That's why doctors tells you to have a liquid diet. Most of the people think that for digestion purpose, doctor has mentioned you to have a liquid diet, but that is not the reason. Logical reason is to increase the count of your platelets in your body. The more count you have in your body of platelets, more healthy and more, you know, exuberant your body is. So who can donate those platelets? For platelet donation, you have to go through three major criteria. First criteria is most important is that your weight should be minimum 55 kg. You cannot donate your platelets if your weight is 54 kg. Second is at least in a life, you should have done one blood donation. That is the this. You cannot jump and become a platelet donor directly. What you have to do is at least once you have to donate the blood. And then third major criteria, the veins of your hands. Now, what are veins? See, mostly donation is done by the veins over here. So these veins, the diameter of these veins should be proper. Like they should be comparatively bigger so that, you know, donation can be performed. So when you scan people throughout these three criteria, especially the vein thing from where you're going to donate the platelets, when you scan around 500 people, you may get one or two platelet donors. So you can just understand how important it is to, you know, scan majority of people so that we can get these platelet donors. Okay. So once you get selected, there is a small blood test is performed on your blood, 10 minutes per test. We call it as a rapid testing. In that, your parameters are checked. Means your hemoglobin should be 12.5 above, and your platelet count, as I said earlier, platelet count, normal platelet count is 1.5 lakh to 4.5 lakh. But suppose if you want to donate a platelet to the patient, then your count should be above 2 lakhs. Okay, 2 lakhs of platelet count should be there present in your blood, and these two parameters are checked, and then you can become a platelet donor.
Wow, that was quite interesting, and the process of donating a platelet was quite interesting, because as a normal person, you know, we just know about donating blood, but now since you have given us this information, it is my duty now to spread this awareness through my channel and tell everyone that, you know, there is something called as platelet donation as well, and you can save a life. So just a question, like, in case someone wants to donate their platelets, where do they reach? Like, where do they go to? Like, which bank or which hospital they go to?
Okay. So, if suppose somebody wants to donate a platelet, first thing they have to understand that at least they should have done one blood donation before. Okay. Then yes, they have to go to any, and even though they have not done the blood donation, they can at least do a first blood donation and then they can plan for a platelet donation. So what are the steps? First, you have to find out nearest blood bank near you. Okay. Mm-hmm. Every blood bank doesn't have this machine for this, you know, collecting a platelet. So how to identify whether that, you know, blood bank has this facility or not? So if that blood banks, under that, the name of the blood bank, if they have mentioned that they provide the apheresis process, this platelet donation ka process is called apheresis process. It's just a Greek word. Apheresis means just to separate out. If this blood bank has written on their website or, you know, in their indexing that we provide an apheresis process, it means they have the facility of the platelet donation. So what they have to do is, as a donor, they have to go and check their weight. Weight should be 55 above. Then they have to, you know, consult with the doctor and technician and check their vein, whether vein is prominent or not. If the weight is proper, vein is prominent, and if they have done blood donation once, at least one blood donation, they qualify for the platelet donation. And then the doctor and technician, you know, plan the activity. Whenever there is an emergency, they call you up. You have to go and donate the platelet. It is as simple as that.
And also, we know that when we do a normal blood donation, it is that we can do the blood donation four times because the red blood cells are renewed every 120 days. What is the case with the platelets? Can you please tell us in detail?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Now I'll come to some interesting facts about the platelet donation. So like a blood donation, you can do blood donation max to max 4 times in a year, one after every 3 months. But the interesting fact about the platelets, you can donate your platelets after every 15 days. Okay, so in a year, you can donate your platelets for 24 times. Why it is so? Because in platelet donation, only platelets are taken out from your body. Rest of the component of the blood, like RBC, WBC, plasma, has been returned to your body. So only loss you have is just of a platelets. So these platelets are recovered in 6 hours of a time. 6 to 7 hours, mein, your platelets are recovered. So that's why you can, you know, donate it 24 times in a year. Second is, mostly people ask, what if platelets are a blood clotting factor? What if I donate a platelets and while returning home, if I meet with an accident, serious accident, then can I survive? Because the job of platelets is blood clotting. And suppose if I meet with a serious accident, can I survive? So guys, remember that 100% you can survive. Why? In this procedure, only 95 ml concentrated platelets are taken out from your body. It is equivalent to having 5 times urination in a day. Once you do 5 times urination in a day, the amount of platelets are going to go out of your body. Those many platelets you are going to donate. So don't you worry, the survival chances are 100%. Next question people normally raises is that why I should do? Like, why it's necessary? Why I should take initiative and do? So always remember guys, anyways, platelets, lifespan of platelets is just 5 days. Suppose if they get created today, anyways, they are going to stay 5 days in your body. On the 5th day, they will flush out through urine out of your body. So anyways, if they are going to flush out, why not save somebody's life and give another chance to live? So that is the thing. Another interesting question that people ask me, they get confused about, like once they donate a platelet, they donate for free of cost, but blood bank sells it for 11,000, that back. So guys, logically, please understand why they're selling it for 11,000. They're literally not earning money out of your component. The major thing is the machine and the kit which is required for blood separation. It is been, cost around 8,000 or 8,500. So, for every donor, they have to use a new kit. Once that platelets are taken out, these platelets are being tested with some, procedures that cost around 1,000 or 1,500. And blood bank might be and again, you have to store the platelets in a proper condition. So normally blood bank might be earning 500 to 1,000 rupees out of that, which is valid because the technician required over there has to be technically very strong and knowledgeable to handle that. Second is the maintenance of the machine, calibration of the machine has to be done on a proper basis. So that's why they have to charge. So the in future, if we start the projects like Made in India and all, then we can, provide these components even more less cost as compared to 11,000.
Mm-hmm. That is quite interesting. And for a person who does not know any information about platelets, it's very informative. The next question which I would like to ask you is, it's quite personal because a couple of years before, I fell sick and then, I went to the doctor, they did a lot of tests and then the doctor said the platelets are low. A non-medical background person will not know because I was hearing it for the first time. And eventually I got to know, I read about it and then I forgot about it. Then when Larry messaged me, we can do an interesting topic on my channel and we can talk about platelets. Then I got to know more about it. And now when I'm having a conversation with you, the knowledge is increased to next level. But if a normal person who does not know anything about platelets and they go for a test and they get to know their platelets is low or it is high, then what is the first thing the person needs to do? Like first thing, they don't need to worry, that is for sure. But the other things, and what is the meaning? Like what is the meaning when the platelet is low and what is the meaning when the platelets are high? If you can just put some light on that and explain us this.
Okay. Platelets are low. It means there are some internal injuries which are happening in your body for which brain is completely trying to recover every injury in your body. That injury might be due to some virus, fungal infection or anything. Okay. So your body isn't in a recovery mode. It If it is in a recovery mode, then your platelets count are less. So you don't need to panic. Three things you have to do. Always remember, guys, three things. First, you should drink plenty of water and liquid. Okay, juices, liquid, whatever. The best way is to drink plenty of water. That is the best solution. Second is you should have a major dry fruits in your diet. Third, you should have is fruits like pomegranate. Such a fruit increases your platelet count tremendously. So these are the fundamental things you have to do. And most important, you should sleep 6 to 7 hours every night, and that too in between 11 to 6 o'clock in the morning. Majority of people are, why these platelets are less? Because nowadays, if you see, centralized obesity is the major problem the world is facing. Second, if you notice people in 30s, they are looking like a 40s or, you know, into 50s because their hair and skin is damaged. The if your hair and skin is damaged, it is only because your platelet count is way less. So in that case, what you have to do is, at any cost, you should sleep early and you should have 6 to 7 hours of sleep. That's it. Healthy lifestyle is required.
Yes, yes, yes. And the correct information about platelets is very, very important, because fun fact, when I got to know my platelets was low, I started imagining something else. I started praying to God 10 times a day, and I was having like 10 to 20 beetroots a day. And, you know, I was just panicking. But if you have the right information, then when I went and spoke to the doctor, he gave me proper medication and then it was fine. So yeah, the correct information is very necessary. And Larry, my co-host, if he would like to ask anything else.
I know Vishwajit sir for quite some time, and it was his passion that really attracted me to what he is doing. Not many of you know, but I know a little bit about him, and there is a lot to know about him. First and foremost, he is blessed with a very rare blood group, that is AB negative, and which is again a very rare thing to have in today's world. And another thing is, he has taken this passion of educating about platelets donation, not only educating, but also screening people or screening youth towards platelet donations. And so far he screened over 10,000 volunteers into platelet donation. It is a remarkable feat. I just want to know, what has been the journey like?
Yeah, at the age of 18, I started donating my blood. By the time I become a 19 or 20, I got to know about the platelet donation. I become a platelet donor, and that eventually journey started off. And, you know, I started, donating in a regular basis and everything. And somewhere down the line, I developed the ego that I'm helping people. But actually, I understood that this problem cannot be solved if only one person is donating the platelets. So what I did was, I decided the most important thing over here is start creating an awareness about it. And I travel all over India, and what I found it out is that what is the biggest mistake we are committing in India is that we are spending a lot of money on creating awareness. What is lacking is the education. So what I did was, like, I flew to America and I studied what is blood. Okay, what is blood? What are platelets? If suppose I am educating somebody, then I should be very clear about what I'm talking about. And I came back and I, you know, simple formula funda, I started a concept called blood bank tourism, because this knowledge is very complicated, you know, very non-attractive. So I started with a funda called blood bank tourism. I started giving the people a 20 minutes ka joy ride. I requested them to come to blood bank and, you know, spend a 20 minutes. And during that 20 minutes, I started showing them practically what is RBC, what is WBC, what is plasma and platelets, and how at least you do become a donor or not, if you want to donate your platelets or not, that is the secondary, but at least if your patient needs a blood or RBC or plasma platelets, at least you should identify the safety of that component. And believe me, that process started 2017, from 2017, one after another, people started, you know, like, connecting, and today we have reached to almost 45,000 common citizen across India, and I have created thousands of volunteers who are passing this knowledge with their capacity in the colleges, in the communities, and through your platform like you, they're taking this initiative forward. So my journey has been amazing, and I wish the people, whoever listening this or watching this, also at least think of donating their platelets and helping somebody save their life. So this is my journey.
Definitely. There will be like more than 100, 200 people will be interested now, you know, after listening to this, interested in donating platelets. And your journey was quite interesting. I got to know about you from Larry. He messaged me and he told me that, you know, there is a person called as Mr. Vishwajit and he's doing such an amazing job. So hats off to you. We don't have the hat, but you have the hat right now. But hats off to you.
And thank you so much.
Continue doing whatever you are doing right now, and lots of love, and thank you once again for coming.
Well, thank you guys for listening. I hope you have learned something valuable from this episode. You know what to do. Start donating your blood and save other people's life, and also spread happiness. Thanks, and see you guys next week.